Now, I will take this opportunity to open the floor for you, our honored guests. But before I move on with the questions, which I presume many of you will have, I would like to tell you why Strategy International has been so keen in helping out the transatlantic community itself, not only European, but also transatlantic, in the sense of international organizations, in the sense of the EU, in the sense of NATO. We're a social think tank. We're an international perspectives think tank. We're the connecting tie between professionalism and academia. This gives us credibility in what we do as long as we take initiatives. NATO is all about initiatives. NATO is all about initiatives, not only in terms of military purposes, but also political purposes. And we are keen in having the political side. Now, the most important thing, and I will come to the question here, is where does NATO go with this alliance? The answer is clear. NATO is going towards its own society. It will emerge stronger from this. It will emerge stronger since it had an important and completed operation in Libya. It will complete its operation in Afghanistan successfully, which gives it credibility to its own people, to its own members, as long as they have the potential to do something, to do it. An example case are social media. We have been managing for the last 4 years a social media network of people that are of young generation, that have the knowledge and the willingness, but some of them do have the expertise and some of them don't. The connecting tie is the transatlantic link. That transatlantic link makes us international as people. And that is why international organizations are more important than any other time in this period that we live in. So I will ask my question, to be blunt, to Ino, and you know, I'm using these powers and I'm using my powers to ask her the first question, is should we expect a further, as we call it in the EU terms, integration of states within the NATO alliance? Will we see more development? Will we see more engagement? Will we see any more assets from the point of view of alliance members to NATO itself? And number two, do you think that Greece should take a lead up, a step up, with the opportunity that we have holding the operation of the NRF under our hands? Thank you. You may feel free also to ask more questions, please. Yes.
Thank you. We know today that the world population is about 7 billion people, and the relevant scientists are saying that in the year 2050, the world population will be about 9 billion people. Nowadays, with 7 billion people, we have a lot of problems around the world, mainly problems relevant to food, and there is poverty in a lot of areas. In some countries or almost continents. Do you see as NATO, let's say, representative today, a significant instability problem or problem relevant to security in the year 2050 or about 2050, which will be created of the so rapidly increase of the world population? Are you thinking about this problem? Are you preparing for this problem, or simply you discuss about it? Thank you.
May I take this opportunity to declare Mr. Zoukas, he's the honorable commander of the Third Corps. So he led, not only he was operational in Kosovo, but he also led at the Third Corps and the NDC itself. So his question is very valid, and we thank you for this. I will take one more question, and we'll take it as a group. If there is one, please feel free. Shall I go with two questions? Yes. Thank you.
Thank you for your questions. Look, I would say that as our colleagues in the panel, I anticipate they raise also the issue of uncertainty in the international environment, which is very central. So I'm not coming here with prefabricated answers or solution. And this is the added value of gatherings of a meeting like this. So I would be as frank as possible with you at this opening of our third conference. NATO is certainly in the center of international security architecture since it is the only military political organization with members in American and European continent. But NATO also cherishes very much the partnerships, meaning that beyond the 28 member states, there is a network of partner states across the globe, Mediterranean, Middle East, Caucasus, Central Asia, Russia, Ukraine, Afghanistan, Australia, New Zealand, Japan, South Korea. And partnership is in the center of the debate in NATO, not only with states, but with international organizations as well, like UN, European Union, African Union. Why? Because as we have discussed many times, NATO is not considering itself the only holder of truth or power. It's an organization open to... Okay, thank you. All right. It's an organization open to dialogue with all players around the globe. Why? Because we have realized after the end of the Cold War, and especially after the emergence of new threats and challenges, that NATO alone cannot face all the challenges the world is facing. It is in the center of international debate and architecture, but on the other hand, there are limits in the capacity. And on the also, it's not that there are limits in the military capacity. It's important to have a dialogue with all stakeholders, because after all, the world, from our point of view, should be governed in a democratic way. So we cannot have efficient military activity without a solid political legitimacy. All the discussion the alliance has launched during the last years demonstrates that we are open to ideas coming from other partners and players across the globe, that we are not considering ourselves the most powerful or the most knowledgeable organization. And I think this has enriched the debate and the actions of the alliance. Now, coming to what the general said, I think you touched upon a very critical issue. That our community, transatlantic community, will face in the coming decades. You spoke about food. I can speak about climate change, which is connected with food and overpopulation. But certainly these are not threats, because you cannot blame people that are having a problem with food to nourish themselves. We cannot blame them, or you cannot take action against them. But certainly, scarcity of food, overpopulation, and climate change create a different environment for international organizations because they create population movements and can lead to conflicts. So certainly the debate is open, but I'm afraid, I mean, I would be very arrogant if I would say that we have the solution. But certainly these are exactly the kind of threats or challenges that international organizations like NATO become to face.